It happened right here on CNN. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen now saying she was wrong about how serious inflation would be.
I think I was wrong then about the path that inflation would take. As I mentioned, there have been unanticipated and large shocks to the economy that have boosted energy and food prices and supply bottlenecks that have affected our economy badly that I didn't, at the time, didn't fully understand.
Joining us now, Larry Summers, the former Treasury Secretary under former President Clinton and former Director of the White House National Economic Council under President Obama. He has been warning about inflation for more than a year. And Mr. Secretary, when you hear Secretary Yellen say unanticipated shocks, is that a fair statement? Because you've sort of been anticipating the heck out of this.
Look, I think the consensus last spring was wrong. The consensus didn't see the overheating risk. I've been wrong plenty of times in my life, but I did see that there was a very substantial demand pressure that was building, and it seemed plausible given that, that there would be bottlenecks. But I think in fairness to Secretary Yellen and in fairness to the Federal Reserve, what they were echoing was a consensus view of economists at that time. That consensus has turned out to be wrong, and I think that does require some rethinking of conventional models among the economists who do these forecasting, nowhere more important than the Fed, which is why I talked about the need for some institutional soul searching there. But I think the important issue is looking forward, and I was gratified by what Secretary Yellen said about the primacy of the inflation problem. I thought the president's orientation in his comments yesterday to inflation as our central problem and to monetary policy as the first line of solution in a completely depoliticized way were just right.
Is the Fed acting enough quickly enough?
I hope so. I'm not certain. I think the test is going to come over the next 6 months. The temptation is always to stop the antibiotic as soon as you feel better. And that can often be the wrong thing to do that makes the problem come back later. And something similar is true with respect to monetary restraint. And I think we need to be very careful to make sure that if we have a few good months on inflation that are better and a few months when the economy looks a little bit weaker, that we don't ease monetary policy or stop tightening it too rapidly. Here's the core fact. We've never stopped an inflation without raising interest rates by considerably more than inflation went up. Inflation has gone up a lot. By some measures, it's gone up 4%. There are even measures where it's gone up 6%. So far, interest rates have only gone up by less than 1%. So I think that in all likelihood, to contain inflation, we've got substantially more interest rate increasing ahead of us. That could turn out to be wrong because it could turn out that the economy weakens much, much more in the next few months than most observers now expect. But I think that's what we've got to keep in mind, what's been necessary in the past to contain inflation.
Sounds like what you're saying is that to contain inflation, we need either a recession, which is not something that most people, most consumers certainly want to see, or raising interest rates as much as 4% from where it is, which is would be an enormous increase.
I think that is the lesson of history. Here's the unfortunate, painful fact, and it's true of the U.S. experience, and it's true of the experience of other rich countries like us. When inflation's above 4%, and unemployment's below 4, you are almost certain to have a recession within the next 2 years.
How bad?
Now, we may somehow find a way of beating the odds and having a soft landing, but it would be a historic counterexample, not a historic norm, if that proves to be true.
When you talk about a recession coming, how bad do you think it could be?
I think that people have an impression of a recession like what happened with respect to the pandemic or what happened in the great financial crisis. I don't minimize the pain associated with recessions, but I don't think we're talking about anything like double-digit unemployment necessarily. I think, and I would not expect that. I think the risk is that if we make the mistakes we made in the 1970s and don't confront this squarely and firmly and immediately with respect to inflation, then we're setting the stage for a really large problem.
You think tax increases should be on the table?
I do think that taking back some of the huge windfall that President Trump conferred on the corporate sector would be a good idea. I think it would tend to help better balance demand and supply. I think if it was done in the right way, it would foster international tax cooperation that would cause more investment to take place within the United States and go after tax havens. I think a great thing that Secretary Yellen did was drive the effort to have a global tax treaty so that the biggest companies and most profitable companies in the world couldn't go hide in tax havens and escape paying taxes. But that treaty is going to languish unless the United States passes the necessary legislation. And so whatever happens with respect to all of Build Back Better, I certainly hope that we will do that. It'll be good for inflation. It'll be good for fairness. It'll be good for international tax cooperation. And it'll be good for strengthening the domestic economy.
Former Treasury Secretary Larry Summers, we appreciate you being with us this morning. Thank you. Joining us now, anchor of CNN Newsroom and master of law, Poppy Harlow.
Please.
It's great to have you here.
Thanks, Berman. Master of everything.
listen, it is unusual to hear such a senior official say something so blunt. I was wrong.
But it's so important. I've always thought the best leaders in business or Washington actually say when they were wrong and learn from it. So she's like the smartest woman slash person on economics, period. And she said, we got it wrong. To be fair, I mean, it wasn't just Treasury and the White House that got it wrong. Almost every economist got it wrong. However, right after that, Treasury put out a statement to our MJ Lee, basically tamping it down and saying, well, there were all of these unforeseen circumstances, so obviously we didn't get everything right. Yes, there were unforeseen circumstances, but we were in a once-in-a-lifetime pandemic that we didn't know which way it was going to go. And people, Democrats, Larry Summers, and some others got it right and kept warning the White House, and they didn't change their position, and they kept saying inflation is transitory. There are a few other things, though, solutions that the White House can do, right? Because in this Biden op-ed yesterday, they laid out some things, but they're like years in the making. They take years to actually come to fruition. So what can the White House do now? They can change some of the immigration policies to deal with the labor shortage. That would help a little bit. They'd face GOP pushback and criticism, but they could do that. They could do what Biden said they're considering 3 weeks ago, which is lift some or all of these tariffs on $300 billion in Chinese goods. I mean, that would make a real difference now and in just a year. The Peterson Institute economists there say if you lift those tariffs, the Trump-era tariffs, that, by the way, Janet Yellen criticizes being counterproductive, you would alleviate about 0.3% on inflation now, about a point in a year. Washington Post editorial board said, look, you've got to stop focusing on being tough on China on this front because they're not adhering to the deal anyways. Be smart on China. Mark Zandi said, this is a good idea. He said, if you do this, you can shave off about a point on inflation, too. So they can do things now, but they have political costs. You have to stomach those costs and criticism now to alleviate some of this pain for every American closer to the midterms.
No easy decisions here, clearly, politically or otherwise.
They didn't sign up for an easy job.
That's a great point. Poppy Harlow, great to have you back. Thanks so much.
John.